Mineral Resources Minister Gwede Mantashe says the death toll following seismic events at the Sibanye-Stillwater mine in Driefontein near Carltonville now stands at 5 mine workers, with 2 still trapped underground. 13 mine workers were trapped on Thursday. Mantashe briefed the media last night after a meeting with management. Chriselda Lewis filed the following report.
The deadly shaft, which claimed the lives of 4 miners. A 3.5 magnitude tremor resulted in a rock fall, trapping several miners, airlifted to hospitals, while others remain critical.
So we'll continue until we've recovered them. Okay, there's another one.
Okay, there's a seismic event, Francis, just took place. The ground has just started shaking. That was quite scary right there. 2 more tremors rocked the mine on Friday afternoon, halting the search for over an hour. As I'm conducting this interview with James, another seismic event with the ground really shaking quite scary, I must say. 7 fatalities have already been recorded here since the beginning of the year. Unions are concerned.
There was a similar accident that took life of 2 fatal accidents at the very same Sibanye. So this is a growing trend on Sibanye. And as NUM, we are very much worried about the safety of this company.
This death in the mine must be treated as a human right issue. Until such time, we see some of this captain of this industry being arrested and be put behind bars, I don't think they will put more emphasis in the safety.
The Mineral Resources Minister has raised concern about the rising number of fatalities in the gold sector, of which Sibanye-Stillwater is a major contributor.
A mining company has a responsibility to provide a safe workplace. That cannot be transferred, it can't be outsourced. It's the responsibility of mine management. And therefore, workers are participants in a primary responsibility of management to ensure that the working place is safe.
The mine is adamant those trapped will be brought to surface.
More and more concerning for the outlook for the employees that are still trapped, but we will continue with our efforts and try and access them and get them out as soon as possible. We can only move as fast as we can without affecting the safety of other people.
Sibanye Gold says the families of the deceased will be transported to the mine, where they will receive counselling. As the hours pass, hopes of finding the trapped miners alive are fading. But the mine says it will work around the clock to bring them to surface. Chriselda Lewis, SABC News, at the Sibanye Mine in Carltonville.